So you want to learn how to do a custom boot screen. It's probably going to look something like this. So if you've watched my previous tutorials, you know how to hook this up to the MKS. So in a moment, I'll show you how to make your own custom boot screen. Okay, the first thing we need to do to create a boot screen is open up Paint. Next thing after that is we need to change the size, so we're going to change it to pixels. I already have it set for 128 by 64 by turning off the maintain aspect ratio. So click OK. Now we're going to zoom in on it. And then we're going to add some text for simplicity here. So we'll say, please like and subscribe. Now what we need to do is save it. So we're going to go over to save as, or actually just save. We're going to call it boot screen and it's going to be a PNG. So we're just going to click the one that I already have. And we're going to click save. And in a moment, I'll show you on the Marlin website how we're going to convert it. Okay, we're on the Marlin website and we're going to use their tool to convert. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose a file. In this case, it's going to be bootscreen.png. I'm going to open that up and then I'm going to make it binary. And then down below, I'm going to copy this in just a moment and show you how to deal with it. Okay, we're going to open up marlin-bugfix-1.1.9 and then the Marlin subfolder. And what we're looking for is underscore boot screen, which I don't see here. So we're going to go to the example configurations and open that up. And then we're going to go to gcreate and open that up. And then gmax1.5+. And we're going to copy the boot screen out and go up to our regular directory and paste it here. In a moment, I'll show you how to modify the custom boot screen and then modify Marlin. Okay, we want to go back to where we generated the file and we're going to copy this. Then we're going to go over to Notepad. We're going to open that up and we're going to paste it right here. Next, we're going to open up the Marlin boot screen and we're going to scroll down, and the first thing that we need to do is change the bitmap width to 128, and then we want to go back to what we just copied and highlight from here down to here and copy that. Then we're going to go back to boot screen. We're going to start at the beginning of the line. We're going to highlight it. And we're going to paste right here. Then we're going to save it with a Control S. And we're going to close this out. And in a moment, I'll show you in Marlin how we're going to install the custom boot screen. Okay, the next thing we're gonna do is press M on the keyboard. And we're gonna open up the Marlin.ino. We're gonna go to the configuration.h tab. And we're gonna do a search on custom. And what we have here is define space show underscore custom underscore boot screen. It's commented, so we're going to remove the comments. Next, we're going to search on motherboard. And currently, it has board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB. We're going to change that to board underscore MKS underscore Gen underscore L. And then finally, we're going to search on full graphic. So that's full underscore graphic. And what we have here says that we need to have a library installed. Now, I already have it installed, but I'm going to show you how to install it real quick here, or at least walk you through most of the steps. So we're going to go to Tools, Manage Libraries. And you're going to type u8glib. And at the very bottom, select this one when it comes up. Select the highest version, then install. And in my case, I already have it, so I'm going to close out of this. The next thing that I need to do is I need to scroll down to RepRap underscore discount underscore full underscore graphic underscore smart controller. And it's commented out, so we need to remove the comments. So what we're going to do is we're going to compile and upload. So we have to check to make sure that we have the right COM port selected, which we do. And we also have the Mega 2560 selected for our chipset, which is correct. So when I press this button, it's going to compile first and then upload. And in a moment, I'll show you how to test it. Okay, now that it's uploaded, I'm going to show you how to test it. So I'm going to remove the USB. Now I'm going to let it boot back up. And the first thing you see is obviously it powers. Then it'll show our boot screen. And then finally, it'll show the status screen after the Marlin version. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.